Dr. Paulie Gloves Gavoni.
Oh, man.
Man, I'm so glad. I'm glad to get you from Florida to Jersey.
Stoked.
Tell me a little bit about how you weave behavioral science into coaching athletes.
I mean, you know, first of all, like, I know there's like a lot of academics out there, you know, so a lot of people know a lot more about the science than I do. I'm very, you know, I like to apply the basic principles, and I like to find tools that are just practical, easy to implement, but of course, you know, using science. So like, for example, very simply, behavior skills training, you know, so instruction modeling, you know, rehearsal with feedback, so, you know, really shaping that behavior, but task analyzing, you know, so having to break down moves into the, you know, their components.
Into pieces and then chain them together.
Yeah, chain them together, so you gotta shape it up, break it down to that. You know, making sure we're not giving them too many behaviors to work on. I'm really trying to focus on what are a couple of the critical habits. So, you know, maybe behavioral cusps.
Yeah.
You know, focus on a couple of behavioral cusps. And, you know, like core rotation is one of those things, like in your stance in mixed martial arts. And then, and this links to the book, it's not good enough just to develop the skills, but it's about transfer of the skills into a natural environment. This is a big thing that people struggle with, whether it's in education, in schools, because, you know, I've done a lot of work in schools, and also in organizations. I think, you know, that you're only getting about like a 10% return on investment when it comes to training. So, you know, there's a very specific things that you need to do to help those skills transfer. So getting fighters to be able to maybe slip a punch outside of the cage and then go into the cage and effectively slip the punch and get in touch with some, you know, naturally occurring reinforcement, i.e. I'm not getting hit, which is a good thing. So they want to do that more. You know,
I don't think I wouldn't take a shot at you. Nah, I'd be scared to do that.
Nah, dude, nah. I get paid to fight, man.
Now, when you talk about transferring skills, do you mean, is one of the factors possibly where someone may be able to engage in a certain action in practice very well, but then when they're under pressure in a cage, they could have challenges with it?
Yeah, it's perfect. You just said it perfectly. So you might be able to learn the skill in this kind of contrived environment, in the training environment, right? So there's the post-training environment. And so how do I get... People are going to fall back to the old habits. I mean, you and I were talking about this before, especially under stress.
Yeah.
When you become stressed, you become like, you know, tunnel vision, for lack of a better term. And you're going to fall back on old habits. So in mixed martial arts or any combat sports, old habit will be like, somebody's trying to hit me, I'm going to do the things that I feel safest. And you're not going to try to apply some sort of new skill if you feel that you're in danger.
Yep.
So, you know, what does that look like in that setting? Well, you know, I want to put them under live conditions, but I'm not going to have, let's say, again, in for the viewer, slipping a punch would be just moving your head out of the way, and so you avoid a punch, and it's putting you in a position where you can throw a counter punch. In this condition, if they're just learning this new skill, I'm not going to have put them in there with a professional fighter and have the professional fighter throw all the repertoire at them, because they're going to go back to the old skills. But I might have them just throw a live right hand, and that gives them ample opportunity to slip the punch, especially if I have them do it maybe at 50%, so they can see it coming. And now, as a coach, I can maybe give them a little bit of feedback to make those tweaks in there so they're doing it successfully. Mm-hmm. And then I start to have the opponent throw the punch a little faster, a little faster, a little faster. So now we're at live speed. And then I slowly, we fade in some other, their repertoire, you know, their skills rather. Mm-hmm. So now they're on the 1-2 and the 1-2-3 and then everything else. And now, hey, these guys are successfully slipping the punch. They're getting to see the condition under which they should do it. They're doing it correctly because they've gotten lots of training outside the cage, so they can actually have the skill. But if you try to teach people under those conditions, right, they don't actually have the skill, it's very hard to coach that, because first you have to get them to acquire the skill.
Yep.
And this is what we do with the book. We separate coaching from training, and I think we might be the first to ever have done it, to define coaching by form and function. That is, training is concerned with skill acquisition, and coaching is concerned with transference of those skills into the natural environment. But I have to make sure that the skill exists first before I can get that skill to transfer, if that makes sense.
Yeah, you got to establish that in the repertoire before you can. So you like to systematically teach things under controlled conditions in an environment where you can initially have the fighter doing something at or someone who's throwing a punch, they might throw it at a slower rate so that the person can learn the form.
That's right.
In an appropriate way under controlled conditions without stress.
Yep.
And then little by little, they might start to increase their speed, maybe successful approximations towards. That's awesome.
And then we use simulation, you know, so the simulated fight, you know, which is sparring, you know, until we go to live. I mean, you can't quite reproduce a live fight because you can't put that kind of pressure on like a live crowd, you know, your record's on the line, all these different things, money's on the line, it's professional, you know. But you do the best you can through sparring and those kind of conditions. But you have to, you know, you just said it perfectly.